Okay, onto a little video here and talk about some of these 20 gauge sabot slugs that I recovered and how accuracy appears to be. I don't have any shooting footage or anything, or targets or anything, but see, here's one that's unfired Lyman 20 gauge sabot slug. It has the hot glue filled base. This is one of the earlier ones that I fired that didn't have the filled base, and they tumbled like a lot of the times. Once in a while they'd go straight forward, but the wad was being shoved up in the back of them. So here's the first time that I fired them with the glue in it. You can see it's still there. You can see how much it bunched up compared to the. This one went through the target, through a, I guess like a piece of a birch about that big, and then buried into the ground. These are all wheel weight. I do have some with pure lead, but I haven't tried those yet. You can see how much it smushes. And the base expands quite a bit, even being wheel weight. And you can actually see the grooves, lines in it where it expanded out into these cutout areas on the shot cup where I cut those ribs out of these Remington wads here. So then these other three here were the one next ones I tested. This one went through the target and it went into about, that much dirt dug into. There were some rocks on the ground, so this damage here was from that. Ripped this piece off. You still see the base there. These all hit. All these ones after I started putting the filling the bases in, they all went front forward. They didn't have any more tumbling issues. So that one was fired. Let's see, that one was fired from about 35 yards or so, and it hit. They seemed to, maybe if you shoot it like 10 yards, 30 yards, 40 yards, they all seem to hit similar elevation. There's a bit of windage variation, but it's just the con arms, like the 20-inch cylinder bore anyway, and at the bead sight. So then this is the next one that was fired at about maybe 25 yards or so. See, it still has its base, and it crushed down pretty good compared to the unfired one. This went into the same type of soil, and it, I think it hit some rocks and stuff, but didn't, it broke up as much as that one. This one here was fired into hardwood. It was like a maple tree that was about this big, and it was dead like quite a while, and it was almost, rock hard. And it was one about this big in the front, and then right behind it there was one about this big. So this slug, it went through the front one. I hit sort of, didn't hit it quite dead center, it hit more kind of on the left side of it. I shot it from, I don't know, 10 yards away or something. Went right through that, blew the back of that tree off. You could see like where this bullet went in, perfect round hole, so it hit forward. And then there's an imprint that was sort of like up about here. Remember, you could see the wad had smacked the tree. And then this dug its way into the tree behind it, and it was in about, it must have been about that far, I guess. And it hit a, there was a bit of a knot there, and it, I think the knot kind of turned it or stopped it, but it was lodged in kind of like, I forget which way, but it was still pointing forward. But you can see it smashed it pretty good. See, the base is still, it's trying to squeeze that out a bit, but it's still in there. So a couple of the wads that I recovered. This one, this wad was with this one, the first one fired, because it's clean, so it was like the, one of the first shots. You see the petals came out all right. There's no evidence that the shot cup was trying to be in being shoved up in the back because of the glue stopped it. And this one here, I think, goes with this one. See, it's dirtier. But it's sheared off a couple of these petals. So. But they hit a couple, like some of my shots with some of these earlier ones, I'd hit like a bit to the left, like an inch or 2 inches, like about an inch or so, or 2 inches to the left where I was aiming. And then I had one that went about the exact same, but it was a bit to the right. It kind of goes back and forth. I don't know if petals being sheared off like this causes the variation or whatever, but it might be just the short barrel bead sight kind of thing like that. But I was pretty impressed with the one that I fired from about like 35 yards or so. It actually, the target was about, it was like the bottom out of a, I don't know, like an old plastic drum or something. The plastic was right brittle. It was like that old white kind of plastic that sits in the sun and gets right. But it was kind of like one of those big plastic barrels. I don't know what it was. Thing was, it has like some hoses sticking out of it in a couple different places and stuff. And anyway, it was just some trash in the woods. But there was a inner circle about this big around, and then there was a hole in the middle of that with this black kind of insert thing with a hole in the middle of that. So I was aiming right at that middle hole. And most, all the shots hit within that inner circle, which was about a hand spanned across. So if I was aiming here, I'd hit like here, and then a couple of them I hit like there. But they were all right in line, like the same level as the center aiming point, so might be just some variation with, doesn't, you know, the wad doesn't release well, or some of these seem that they get pretty brutalized, like they're kind of bunched up quite a bit compared to a unfired one. But so I don't know if that really cause issue or not. But so anyway, so that's what I've done so far. Fairly happy with it. It seems to be fairly accurate, but I suppose like maybe at a rifle barrel or something, it might actually work a lot better. But and these are a fairly weak load. It's like 15.5 grains unique, which I think is around like 1,200, no more, probably maybe 1,100. Like I wouldn't mind getting some loads up that were, you know, 13, 14, 1,500. I think the Winchester factories like Foster slug is like 1,600 in a 20, so but so I might try a different load, but or try some of the pure lead ones and see what they do. But it almost seems like this glue filled base like supports it, like it seems like it won't, like it doesn't, like it seems like it makes it expand. I don't know, like this one expanded quite a bit too and it had no base. But it seems like it would, seems like it's resisting it from totally turning itself inside out. But I don't really, because this one here was shot into wood, that it tumbled and everything. And I had the wad for it, but I lost that. But it was actually shoved up into it. So, but they were all over the place, these ones. So they were terrible. But this seems to have fixed the problem. So. It's really easy to put the hot glue into them. See, this one here is a bit in a little bit, but usually I just make it flush and then just cut it off with a knife if it sticks out a bit, so it actually sit up straight. But anyway, thanks for watching.